So about this experiment that Danish people did with plant seeds and to prove how exposure to electromagnetic waves affected them.
Yeah.
What do you think about this study? And can this study be reproduced again in different schools?
Yeah, of course. This study was initiated by six Danish schoolgirls and their teacher. And they used cress seeds and exposed them in a very nice way to various electromagnetic fields. And they kept all the other parameters constant, the light, the amount of light, the amount of water and so on. And then they received very interesting information that these seeds didn't like the exposure from the mobile phones. And of course, this is not a sort of genuine scientific study. There are question marks and so on. And but they have initiated, I think, a very interesting area. And they were not the first. Other scientists doing extremely well-controlled studies, like in France, had already 2008 shown that tomato plants do not like exposure from base station radiation. So that was already out there. And then we said to ourselves that, hey, these Danish schoolgirls and their teacher, they're very clever, actually. And we should try to replicate this. And together with the Belgian scientist, we have started some replications and to do it even more controlled and in a so-called double-blind fashion so that the person that observes this doesn't know this tray of seeds, is it exposed or not?
Okay.
Just reporting all the data, and then you will see, does it fit with the exposure profile or does it not fit? So that's the way it should be done, you know. And the key word is control. Always keep all parameters exactly the same and just change one, exposed or not exposed. All others should be the very same, you know, exactly the same.
Because I think that apart from the fact that this can be very scientific or not, depending on if it is done properly or not, it's also good for normal people who are not scientists to see that they can, you know, themselves, they can try that this is...
Absolutely, and I really invite people to observe their reality. And, you know, in Sweden, when you train as a scientist, as well as a medical doctor, the very first day, you're always taught the following, namely that people living in the reality, which scientists rarely do, you know, they live in laboratories, but people in reality, they observe things and they come up with observations that generally most often are correct. You may not trust them, you may not believe them, the observations may not fit your sort of picture of the world, but they are most often right. So they very often initiate new areas of science and observation and knowledge, and it's very important that people start to report. And they may be wrong, they may be right. It's up to science and society to really scrutinize that. And I often, when I give lectures about science theory in Sweden, I say that as a scientist, you're part of a mental fire brigade. You know, we have ordinary fire brigades to put out fires in our homes and workplaces. But here we have a mental fire. Someone says, hey, something is wrong here. Like you said before, the fertility in Europe is going dramatically down. What's wrong, you know? And also the pollinating insects have disappeared. What's wrong? And then this mental fire brigade, instead of having buckets with water, we have medical statistics, biological statistics. We have control experimentation and so on. We have a toolbox which we can carry with us and run out into reality and test what's going on actually, you know. And sometimes we need, for the sake of control, to take back the whole question to the laboratory, because in the laboratory you can keep it very well controlled. You can contain it in a very controlled situation. And often we also have to make a model instead of looking at human beings. Maybe we have a test tube with cells and so on, and there are different ways to approach this. And but still, it all started by someone said, hey, there is smoke coming here, you need to check this, you know. And when the ordinary fire brigade comes, we are happy if there isn't any fire, if there is a false alarm, and they are happy because they don't have to risk their lives. And coming back to science, as scientists, we are always at the happiest if it turns out that there isn't any risk. But we need to really double check so that not suddenly this fire starts when we have left the place, you know.
And you have nothing to
do. Yeah, then it's too late. We don't have time to run back, you know.
Yeah, okay.
The only thing I always try to teach people that are outside of science, and unfortunately people inside science needs to be taught about that too, is that any given scientific observation always starts with the first paper. Someone is the first to say that, look here, when we did this, this happened. And then after that, so-called replications will follow. And if they are exactly the same, you don't change anything, then you will come up with a paper, number 2, 3, and 4, that either will say that number 1 was right or wrong. They could be used as kind of balances to each other, but there will be a third pile of papers that will be very quickly rising in number, more and more and more and more, and that are papers that have done something else. Very similar, maybe, at least on the surface, it looks very similar, and they don't show any effect. And the only thing you can use them for, actually, is not to use them at all. And in science theory, in the books, it very clearly says that this third pile of papers cannot be used for anything. That's the only you can be taught from that. It's only these exact replications.
Yeah.
And when I talk about this specific field, nowadays there are replications, and as I say, they prove the first ones wrong. And the most famous replication is again the genotoxic effects. And there were American scientists and also scientists in other countries who had shown this. And then the industry said that, no, this is wrong. There are no such effects. And to make a long story short, they gave a lot of money to many laboratories in Europe, in many countries, and they worked very long time, very controlled and very delicate and accurate, you know. And unfortunately, they proved these other scientists correct. And then the industry went to bizarre measures trying to stop this publication, this new study, and they couldn't. So it is published.
Okay.
Which is the name?
The Reflex Study, it's the name.
Study.
Yeah.
To look
so,
for it.
Yeah.